Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. I've got a video on YouTube about Zoom that I think has been played more than 300,000 times, and I've got a couple of other ones that have been played something like 200,000 times. So I get loads and loads of questions from teachers asking me questions about Zoom. And I'm going to go through today the most common problem, and I probably get an email about this literally every single day. So I'm really hoping A, to show you the problem, B, to give you at least three solutions. So I think for a lot of teachers, this video is going to be really useful. Hope you like the video, and if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers, please comment on it if you've got any questions, and of course please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com and sign up to my newsletter and join me on my YouTube channel. You can subscribe to the channel and don't forget to click on the bell to get the updates. Let's get started. So everybody asks me the question, Russell, can I share something with my students when they're in breakout rooms? And the answer is no, you can't. They are actually in separate rooms, completely different breakout rooms to you. So you can't share anything in your breakout room because you're still in your main classroom and they've now gone into breakout rooms, which are different classrooms that they're in. So we have to think of solutions to the problem, and there are various solutions, and what I'm going to try and do is go through the key things like sharing a PowerPoint, playing a video, using the interactive whiteboard, setting up discussion questions, and show you how you can deal with this problem. First problem, and then we're going to talk about interactive whiteboards, and I'm just going to quickly demonstrate this and then show you an answer. So let me show you this. I'm in a breakout room at the moment, okay, and I'm going to just do a screen share, and I'm going to open an interactive whiteboard, and I'm going to just write on the screen really quickly. So I'm just going to click here and write like that, okay? So I've written on the screen. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the main room and open that interactive whiteboard. Let's imagine I'm a student. I've come back to the main room. I want to show my teacher what we've been working on the interactive whiteboard. I click on the interactive whiteboard. Ah, it's not there. That is because I'm not in the same breakout room, am I? I'm back in the main room with my teacher again now. So it's a different interactive whiteboard, just like you've got a different interactive whiteboard in every classroom of your class, or a whiteboard in every classroom of your school. So we have to save the work that we do. So let me show you now how to solve this problem. So I'm in a breakout room, going to go to an interactive whiteboard. I'm going to a different breakout room this time, so there's nothing there. Going to just do a load of work. All I need to do is click on here, and that's all I need to do, actually. I don't even need to click on anything. Now, I'm going to leave the breakout room and come back to the main room. In the main room, the teacher says to me, right, what did your group do? I click on screen share. I click on interactive whiteboard. I open it. I'm a bit surprised there's nothing there, but I come up to save. I click on show in folder, and then I'm relieved to see that it is saved. I double click on it, and then obviously I can start talking about it. And of course, everyone in the group can see what I've saved on my interactive whiteboard. Just a little tip, that is an image. So the best thing to do is once the student's finished is simply for them to click on close the image down, and then obviously they can stop sharing, and then another teacher or the teacher can carry on with the lesson. But that would be the easiest way. Okay, just one final thing about that. You might be asking, well, where is that saved? Just point that out to you. To your documents on a PC, I wouldn't be sure on a Mac, and it's always going to be at the bottom, isn't it? Because it's got the name Zoom, or certainly one of your last files. Just click on it, and it's done by date. And of course, I can see here that I've been saving today's folders, and that's the same place where you save your videos, etc., etc. So it automatically creates a folder with all the content in it when you save your interactive whiteboards, or you save your chat, or even if you save the recordings of your sessions. That you want the students to work in groups and to share a video. Well, what you have to do is you need to go to the video that you want to share, click on it, copy the link, come back into your Zoom session, and then open up your chat window, and then share the link. And you need to do that before the students come, or before the students go into breakout rooms, so that they have got a copy. And what I actually do is I tell them to click on it. so that they've actually got it ready. All right, they can always come back to the Zoom room by just going down to here, but actually make sure that in the background they've got a copy of the video. And that means that when they move into their breakout rooms and someone wants to share the video, they click on screen share, and because they've already opened it, it will be available to them on the screen. Don't forget to click on share computer sound, otherwise the students won't be able to hear the student who plays the video. So that makes sure that the sound also plays along with the video, and then click on share. So you've got to share the video with the students before they move into breakout rooms, and the easiest way to do that is to put them, or to share the link to the video before they move into breakout rooms, in the chat window. That you want to share a document with your students because you want the students to work on that document when they're in groups. What you need to do is share the document in the chat window before you get them to move into breakout rooms, and tell them to open the document so that when they move into breakout rooms, one of the group, only needs one of course, can share their screen, open the document, and then the whole group can see it. So the easiest thing to do then again is to open up the chat window on the right hand side, and remember you can click here on file and come down to your computer. Now you might share a document from various places, but if you want to grab it from your computer, just simply grab a document that you want to open, and then that then is being shared by your group. Now you can't see this because I'm logged into another computer here, but I can see that that document is now open on my screen in my other computer. And on my other computer, because I'm logged in as Tom, it says download, okay? So you can't download it because you're the one that shared the actual link, but the student, or shared the document, but the students will be able to do it. So they can download the document, or download the PowerPoint presentation, or download the PDF file, or whatever you want them to share, before they go into breakout rooms. And that's how you make sure that they can then all work on the same document. Hope you find that video useful. I'm going to find it useful because every time now that someone asks me this question, I can now send them this video with the answer. If you come over to teachertrainingvideos.com, great section on Zoom, loads of videos there. Some of them are very popular. And if you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the blogs and all the webinars and all the online courses that I'm involved in, as well as, of course, information about all the new videos that I upload. The other thing that you can do, of course, is to sign up to the YouTube channel, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to click on the bell. I think we've got 40,000 followers now, something like that. And finally, if you are looking to do some training with me, perhaps training in Zoom or Camtasia or Moodle or Adobe Connect, I'm doing quite a few one-on-one sessions these days, but of course I also do online sessions with groups of teachers training them and using technology, then please contact me from the website, and thank you very much.